Hoi ahoi crew, what class should you play? Well, that depends on what you want. So, if you want to solo end game content, Rune Knight or Guillotine Cross are your best options. It also depends what role do you want to play. Do you want to be DPS, support, or tank? DPS can usually go in most parties in all content. Support is in parties is mandatory, so you can often make a budget support and join a lot of endgame content without needing billions of Zenian gear to actually do damage, or a tank, which nowadays tanks are generally mixed of like part DPS but with a lot of resistance. So they can be expensive depending on where you're going to tank. Not everywhere needs a tank, and tanks are a bit harder to main as a role, but it's still doable. But I would recommend, if you're like new and you want to get into like see the end game content, support's probably the best way. Performers are one of the easiest classes to make. Sorcerers are usually very high demand and are quite necessary for a lot of parties. Soul Reaper is like a off meta, or not an off meta support, but it's kind of a support that's not always needed, but is always kind of welcomed. And then Archbishops, which are probably the hardest support to play, not because maybe they're very hard to play, but because they have literally 8,000 skills, and you can't even, it's so hard to fit them on a single skill bar, and it's Archbishop, you have to actually take a while to learn how all of it works. If you're just making a support just to join parties and see the content, probably make a Soul Reaper performer or a sorcerer. If you really like support and you want to keep and you want to like play that, Archbishop's good then. Or if you want to look very cute, tanks can only go in certain content, and sometimes they need to deal damage, so you end up being like half DPS anyways. This is a lot more complicated, I'd say. And really depends on the content itself, on if your tank can actually do anything, or is useful in any way. So I don't really have much else to say on tanks. DPS is, you know, Rune Knights, Ranger, Guillotine Cross, Genetic. I think almost any class can be a DPS. But yeah, figure out which role you want to play in a party, which is mostly going to be DPS or support. Support being easier, DPS being usually more expensive. And then another question, do you want to play melee, ranged, or magic classes? This is aimed at DPS, not support, and not really tanks, because tanks are generally melee, if they're hybrid. But melee, ranged, or magic, and this significantly will lower the amount of classes you have to scan through, because if you want to play ranged, it doesn't eliminate all the classes, but it eliminates a lot of builds and different options. So it narrows down, so you have less things to choose from. It makes it easier to find something you would like. And do you want to just casually play with friends or a guild? Find whatever class you enjoy most then. Basically just play a bunch of the classes, learn the mechanics, how they work, how their skills function, level them up a little bit, join like Gramps parties to see how they go in parties, and just play a bunch of the classes that look interesting to you. And then if you find one you enjoy, focus on that and invest more of your Zenny and farming and all your effort into that. And if you don't know what you want from your class in RO yet, or what you want to do, you don't know if you want to do solo end game content, or, you know, maybe you're looking for friends or a guild and you don't know what to play yet. You don't know if you like melee, ranged, or magic, or DPS, support, tank. Just explore the classes. Same thing as the last question. Find one you enjoy playing. Find one you enjoy learning how to play. And just basically make sure you're enjoying the game. Because it is a game after all. Even if the game is 90% farming and RNG, you should still find a way to enjoy yourself. Otherwise, you know, what's the point in playing? But yeah, this video may not have helped you find the class you want to play, perhaps, but maybe it helped you limit or search better for what you do want to play. I more or less just want to, like, show that if you are just playing to enjoy the game, you don't really have to worry about, like, playing the meta class, like, being a GX, being Rune Knight so you can do certain things. Because if you play with friends or, like, guilds, you can do a lot of the content, even with off-meta stuff, just because you're in, like, guilds that set up for stuff. Like, if you're a Shadow Chaser who plays Triangle Shot, for instance, you have problems with agi up. So in Bio 5, there's some mobs you can't really deal with very well. But if you have a sorcerer in your guild, they can give you striking, and then that perfect hit allows you to then hit those agi up mobs. You don't have to worry about your downsides because you have friends or a guild to cover for those. So when you play with friends or a guild, I guess is what I'm saying, you don't have to worry about your class's downsides as much as you would if you're trying to be the solo endgame content people, which those people are a lot more limited on their classes because not all classes can do all of the content. But yeah, it's just a short video today I just felt like making. If you enjoyed it, subscribe to the channel, share the video with friends, and I'll see you in the next video.